Do your RV steps? Wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble. Let's talk about that. Chris Dow here with Around the Sun We Go, and if you have the wobbly style of RV step, you're probably looking to upgrade to the new style, which offers a lot more stability. If you don't already know, the old style step is one that folds out from under your rig, and the bottom step simply hovers above the ground without making any contact. Therefore, when you step on that bottom step, you're hovering, and therefore you wobble around like you're on the edge of a diving board. Luckily, our rig, which is a 43-foot toy hauler, it came with a new style of step on our front door, which means we never had to deal with any of those issues at our main entry. But we do have the traditional style on our back door, and having used both, I can tell you the experience is definitely night and day. And especially as full-time RVers, going up and down a wobbly step with 50 pounds of groceries or something big and bulky that's blocking your view, I can definitely understand how that could be an inconvenience on a day-to-day basis. So, if you're looking to upgrade, which brand of new style step is best? Well, two of the most popular offerings on the market today are the Lippert Solid Step and the Moride Step Above Step, which is actually what came installed on our rig from the factory. At first glance, you're not gonna notice much difference between the two. They're both gonna give you increased weight capacity and increased stability. They're both constructed from lightweight, high quality aluminum. They're both stowed inside on travel days, so they're exposed to the elements a lot less. And they both have adjustable independent legs that work great on uneven terrain. Now with that said, there are pros and cons to each, so let's get into that right after you smash the like button. The number one difference between these two models is gonna be the step width and step depth. As you can see here, the Moride Step has a width of 19.5 inches, while the Lippert, on the other hand, has a width of 24 inches. That's 4.5 inches in Lippert's favor, and while that may not sound like much, it can be a huge deal when you're going up and down, especially in the dark.
That's what she said!
And not only are you getting extra width, you're also going to get extra depth. As you can see here, the Lippert Step is 13 inches deep, while the Moride Step is only 8 inches deep. Again, that's an extra 5 inches in Lippert's favor, and if you combine that with the width, you're almost looking at a top platform rather than a top step. But with that extra space does come a slight reduction in weight capacity, which brings us to our second difference between these two steps. While Moride offers a weight capacity of 500 pounds, the Lippert step is only rated for 400 pounds, which should work in most cases, but if you're looking for the highest weight capacity, the Moride is the winner. So the third difference between these two steps is the ease of leg adjustment. Lippert wins here for two reasons in my opinion. The first is the fact that when you remove the adjustment pin on the feet, they automatically drop with gravity to the ground. The Moride steps, on the other hand, require you to manually pull the leg out after you remove the pin, which requires a little bit of leverage and can sometimes be frustrating if you misjudge the distance. The second reason is that the hole tolerances on the adjustment pin seem to be a lot looser on the Lippert step versus the Moride step. This just means it's gonna be a lot easier to get the adjustment pin back in and fully seated. On the Moride, if you don't have the holes lined up just right, you're gonna have a very hard time getting the pin back in, and that can be frustrating, especially after a long day of driving. This brings us to the fourth difference, which is installation. I'm gonna call it a draw here because there are definitely pros and cons to each. The first difference I noticed was the way in which the steps and the assist features were marketed and packaged. By the way, when I mention assist features, I'm referring to the strut-based upgrades that both Lippert and Moride offer. These systems act just like any other strut system you've seen on a trunk or a hood, allowing you to lift the 50 plus pound step with very little strength or effort. If you look on Moride's website, it appears that they offer a step above step without strut assist, and then they offer a step above step with strut assist. So if you wanted the assist feature, you would buy it as a bulk package as a single product. Lippert, on the other hand, offers their step separately and their lift assist separately. So if you wanted both the steps and the assist feature, you would buy two separate products. So while Moride's combo packaging may offer a simpler purchase and installation experience, Lippert's add-on option could allow for more versatility. It really just depends on your preferences and specific application. The next difference in installation is the way in which the steps are mounted to the rig. While the Moride system requires less screws in the floor, only 4 total, it does require wall mounts on both sides of the door frame, which means removal of molding from both sides as well. And while the Lippert system requires many more screws to go into the floor, it only requires a wall mount on one side of the door frame. Lippert's wall mount is taller than Moride's though, which means removal of a much larger piece of molding and also possibly accessories that may be in the way. During our installation, I had to remove the fire extinguisher mount and relocate it about 12 inches up in order to provide clearance for the strut cover. Next up is the difference in the assist feature. Moride wins here hands down. When raising and lowering their system, it's smooth and even from the very top all the way down to the very bottom. Lippert's lift assist feature, however, provides almost no support after you're about 80% of the way up. Same thing applies on the way down. For the first 20% or so, there's no support at all. It almost feels like the steps want to fall out of the door. It's not a big deal once you get used to it, and obviously the strut is going to catch it before it falls all the way, but I could potentially see this bumping someone if it slipped out of their hand at the top of the motion. So, at the end of the day, after having both units installed and using them for some time, I would say that the Lippert Solid Step is the winner. The wider and deeper steps are the main reason for the win, but the foot adjustment is a huge bonus. And while I definitely prefer the smaller footprint and smoother operation of Moride's Strut Assist feature over Lippert's Lift Assist, it's not a big enough deal to take the win. So if I had the old traditional style of RV step and I was looking to upgrade, I would definitely choose the Lippert Solid Step. But if I already had the Moride steps installed on my rig, would I still choose to upgrade? Well, I guess it really just depends on if I felt like balling out or not. I mean, I have had a few close calls over the past 15 months where I've almost missed a step on the Moride system. So if I was looking to protect my knees, my back, my ankles, and my crack, I'd probably go ahead and upgrade. One other quick tip I wanted to mention about the feet on both models. Make sure to put a piece of wood or at least a thick mat between the steps and the ground just to protect the feet from rock damage. The damage you see here was actually sustained the very first night we moved into the rig. We deployed the steps on some gravel, went up and down all night, and then this is what we discovered when we packed up the next day. So that's about it for the pros and cons of the Lippert versus the Moride step. If you're interested in seeing me replace my Moride system with the Lippert system, or if you're curious why I decided to upgrade in the first place, stay tuned because I'll be covering that next. So like I said, our rig came from the factory with the Moride system installed, and we've been using these steps for the past 15 months while living full-time in the rig. So far, we've had no major complaints. They've been solid, they've held up great in all weather conditions, and I would say that most people would find them a welcome upgrade to the old style step. Now, while these steps have performed perfectly over the past 15 months, I was curious to try Lippert's Solid Step, and when they reached out to ask if I'd be interested in doing a product review in exchange for a free set of steps, well, what do you think I said? So like a kid on Christmas, I received my ginormous 165-pound package, took some product shots, then ripped it all open, deciphered the instructions, and prepared myself to install these on the rig. Now, first step for me, since I already had a new style step installed, was figuring out how to best remove the Moride system, which I had no experience with because it came installed on the rig from the factory. Most people, however, will be upgrading from the old style fold under the rig steps and therefore wouldn't have to worry about removing anything from the doorway because the new style of step would be the first thing installed there. And quick side note about the old steps, if you're not going to be using them anymore, you can actually remove them from your rig and leave that space empty. But both Moride and Lippert offer a solution for this empty space, which is an external lockable storage box. If you're interested in seeing an old style set of steps be removed and replaced with one of these storage box solutions, let me know in the comments below and I'll see what I can do. But back to the current install. So it turns out removal of the Moride system was pretty simple. I just removed the strut cover and four screws from each side of the door frame. I then folded the steps up into the doorway and removed two screws from each side of the floor. I then removed two bolts from each side of the door frame plate. At this point, the steps were completely loose and I was able to remove them from the doorway. With the Moride system gone, it was now time to install the Lippert system. So like I mentioned in the pros and cons, the Lippert system includes two separate products. The first is the Solid Step itself, and the second is the Lift Assist Kit. So my first step here was to take the parts from the Lift Assist Kit and attach them to the Solid Step. This simply required me to remove the original threshold plate from the steps and then replace that with the upgraded Lift Assist plate that came in the kit. And then I also had to remove the original transport latch, and then I replaced that with the upgraded Lift Assist transport latch. Both of these swaps were very simple. It was just four bolts on each side for the transport latch, and three bolts on each side for the threshold plate. So with the new hardware attached on the top and the back, it was now time to install the steps into the doorway. After I carefully maneuvered the plate through the threshold, I set the step where it would go in general, and then I used a tape measure to make sure it was in the exact spot as specified by the instructions. I then shut the door, made sure everything lined up, made sure there were no issues. Once I was satisfied, I went inside, found the two pilot holes, and put two wood screws into the floor. This stabilized the steps enough for me to fold them into the doorway. But before I did that, I wanted to put a mat down because this plate will slam into the floor before it's attached to the strut. I was then able to lift the step into the doorway and access the remaining nine holes. I ran the rest of the wood screws, and at this point, the steps were fully installed. Next up was the strut cover, which is installed on the wall to the right of the door frame. So in order to get the cover to mount flush against the wall, I had to remove a piece of molding. I simply marked just above the cover, and then I used a utility blade to slice through the molding. It was soft and pretty simple to do. During our installation, I also had to remove the fire extinguisher mount and relocate it about 12 inches up in order to provide clearance for the strut cover. I then used 8 wood screws to mount the cover to the wall a quarter inch from the door frame. And then the final step was to attach the strut. The kit includes 2 struts, one for small steps, one for larger steps. I used the larger one. I popped it on at the top and the bottom, and then I was done. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. It's the first YouTube video I've ever published, so if you have any feedback for me, feel free to leave that in the comments below. Also, please consider liking, subscribing, and clicking the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos I post. All these actions will let the YouTube algorithm know that I'm doing a good job, and it'll also help me reach many more people who might also get some value from my content. My name is Chris Dow. This is Around the Sun We Go, and remember, make every trip count.